Hello everyone. This week I wanted to do this storage cabinet with lots of drawers that can actually go beneath my table. Now I do a lot of projects here, and because of which the table gets cluttered and I need to store the things which I use regularly in this. Also, I didn't want to put this storage cabinet somewhere else because there is a huge lot of space beneath the table and I can use them to store this cabinet. I'm going to just sit here and work on the board and, you know, on the computer. So this area is totally free and this can actually slide in there, save some space. So let me show you how I did this. The storage cabinet is 16 inches deep and 2 feet tall. It will have 4 drawers. At the bottom, I would raise it about 2.5 inches with a toe kicker. First, I start making the drawers from this long sheet of 12mm plywood. I measure and begin cutting with a circular saw. The cut pieces have rough edges, so I sand it with a sanding block. To cut the pieces to length, I use my crosscut sled. I set a stop block on one end and then push each piece up to it and began cutting them. For the shorter piece, I measure and change the stop block's distance, then cut the rest. This crosscut sled is so heavy, I gotta do a smaller one. Hit thumbs up if you like to see one. To make the drawer, I have to dado the edges on the front and the back pieces. So I set the depth to half of 12mm. Then by setting up the fence, I set the width of the cut to 12mm. I run the front and back pieces through the router and check each piece with a scrap 12mm plywood. This is how they look after I dado the edges. Then to create a slot at the bottom end of all the sides, I change the router bit to 6mm. I'll show you the use of this slot later. By setting the tables of ends, I raise the blade exactly to the end of the slot. Then I trim only the backside pieces of the drawer. When I put the drawers together, you will understand this. Now making the drawers will be easy because all the dado and slots are cut in already. I apply Fevicol glue on the dado and stick the side pieces. Then hold it with brad nails while the glue dries. You can see the backside being shorter because I trimmed the slot. I check for squareness of the box before moving to assemble the next drawer. The drawers will be subjected to pull and push, so to make the joints more secure, I drill some pilot holes, countersink them, and drive in 1/2-inch screws. To create the bottom of these drawers, I cut some 6mm plywood to size. These plywoods will go into the slots that I cut earlier with the router. And the backside being shorter will allow easy access to insert these bottom plywoods. To secure the bottom, I apply some glue before inserting the sheets. The side plywoods are a little bent, so I use some clamps to hold until the glue dries. I pre-drill some holes, countersink them, and then secure it with screws to the backside alone. Please click on the top right corner to see how I made this cabinet. I added some 6mm plywood to give a raised platform to attach the sliders. I first secure one end of the slider to the side and then use a level before I can secure it with the second screw. I measure the height of the slider and mark the other side and then repeat the same steps. To attach the rest, I repeated the same steps and secured the sliders to each of the raised boards. Now I can attach the drawers to the sliders. I pull out the extendable part of the drawer, mark where I have two pre-drill holes and then secure it with screws. The sliders need to be parallel to the drawer. I check this using a level. There could be better ways to do this, but I just followed this way. To create the front faces of the drawer, I used 18mm plywood. Then by setting up the fence, I cut 4 front faces.